Homecoming for Chuck Fairbanks. Remember, he was over at the University of Colorado before he took the New Jersey job. The ball goes to the one-yard line for Thomas Lott. Lott finds a little room in the middle after slipping, and he brings it out across the 20 to about the 23. Here's your offensive alignment now for the New Jersey Generals as they open with Bobby Scott at quarterback. Bobby had a calf muscle problem the last time we saw him, but he's shaking it off. Walker and Carthon are the setbacks. They run out of the eye a lot with Brodsky, McConaughey, the wide people, and Victor Hicks is the tight end. So the New Jersey Generals are going to start it from about the 23 with Mike Freedy and Larry Brodsky and Tom McConaughey. Three wide people in to start the ball game, and that's Freedy in motion, and Scott's going to put it up on the first play. And the pass is incomplete, intended for Tom McConaughey, the wide receiver out of Central Arkansas. The offensive front for New Jersey lines up this way. They have Murtha at 260, Jewell at 255, Ken Hull, the center, at 255, Wayne Harris at 270, Todd Thomas at 260. Thomas is the starting right side tackle. Brian Millard, who had held that job, tore up a knee, and he is gone for the season, though he did not have to have surgery. It is second down and 10 from just inside the 23. This time it is Brodsky in motion. So apparently New Jersey's going to throw on the first series. Victor Hicks, the tight end, comes across to the 32, and he is close to a first down. He may be a half a yard short as Greg Gerken, linebacker, makes the tackle. A little switch now in the Denver defense this weekend. Instead of the 3-4, they have fielded off to go to a 4-3. And with a linebacker up on the outside to make it sometimes a 5-2 with Turner short, Atiye, and Faremba. Linebackers being Gerken, Putschoat, the leading tackler, and Kyle Whittingham. The secondary for Denver, Miller, Dumars, and Tyler, and Martin. Dumars is the second leading tackler on the team. Putschoat is the top tackler. And it is now third down and a yard. This time they go to Herschel Walker. Dirt gets it up to the 35 as he cut it back, and he gets the first down. Andy Faremba, a 245-pound linebacker, originally playing defensive end today out of Colorado State, made the stop.
Keith, in that first series, they came out throwing the ball, just trying to take advantage of what that defense was giving them, trying to get the defense a little bit off guard. I think when they came up and they saw the four down linemen, they said, well, let's wait just a minute here. They're looking for the run. Let's give them a little bit of pass. If we can get them loosened up, our running game will work that much better.
Freedy and McConaughey are the wide receivers now out of the I formation with Walker deep, and Herschel's got the ball going to his left, and he's clobbered behind the line of scrimmage. Herschel is not a particularly effective runner to his left. The offensive line did not get off very well that time either on the left side, but they're playing somewhere between first and second base on the dirt.
That's right. Whittingham and Gerken made the tackle there, and he comes out to his left, and we know that earlier Herschel Walker doesn't run much to his left. And talking with Red Miller, he said the ratio is about 70-30, that he runs 70% of the time to the right. Of course, the last time we did a game with the New Jersey Generals, he only ran one time to the left out of 28 carries.
Loss of a yard, second down, 11, from the 34. Bobby Scott on a roll, goes to the short man, that's Brodsky, and he missed him. Coming across defending was Nate Miller, a rookie out of Cameron.
As we watch Scott run back to the huddle and Larry Brodsky, it's his defensive line that is going to be the key for Denver if they're going to win this ball game. They do have to contain Herschel Walker. Herschel Walker gives them a consistent ground game. And if they can stop that, well, then they're going to force them to the air where they've got a better chance of stopping the New Jersey offense.
Got a nickel defense in there now as the fifth defensive back goes in. Ricky Haar goes in for Denver. And on third down and 11, Scott on a straight drop goes over the middle for Victor Hicks, and Hicks can't hang on. And Victor is high load and hurt. Boy, they really nailed him.
Number 17, Ricky Haar, the substitute back, came in, made a tackle, and Ricky Haar, he needs a little help getting off the field, too.
He don't know where he is. Victor Hicks is a big man, 6'3", 255. Ricky Haar weighs at 190, and they had a heck of a collision.
Well, he's coming across the middle of the field just looking for that opening in his zone defense. You can see number 50 is trailing him, trying to stop the pass from underneath. But the pass gets in, and he just can't hang on to it. Right there, he's taken out about the knee level. Now, some people will say, why would the defensive back come up there? He has a clear shot and take him so low. Well, just what you pointed out, Keith, the difference in size. This small tall defensive back does not want to take on a big, strong tight end up high where he can get hurt. He can still get hurt taking him on low as he did here, but right there, low hit, he doesn't have to grab him, he just chops him down.
Lance Olander will do the punting. Now, Victor Hicks, who has been hit around the knees, well, 2 weeks ago we saw him get hurt a couple of times. He's come off the field and going to get a breath of oxygen, and the oxygen tank is a very handy tool a mile high. So Victor Hicks now is being carried off the field, and he may have quite a serious knee injury, and that is a big loss for New Jersey. Lance Olander, 9 punts all last week, averaging 32 yards, and he's standing back on the grass with David Martin and Ken Brown, 13 and 83. The deep people, a penalty flag sails into the air, and Denver's got the ball, good field position up at the 41. Let's see about the penalty flag. David Martin returning it. He's out of Villanova. Had a tryout with an NFL team, but didn't make it. Now he's found a place to play. Procedure call against New Jersey. I would think Denver would decline it because they've got the ball in good field position. That was a 34-yard punt by Olander.
We have an illegal formation on a kicking team. Refused first down.
Wonder where Tommy's from. Well, they put the ball down now right on the 40. In the first quarter of play, we have no score fee, and Bob Nozolik is the tight end. Nozolik sees the ball quite often. Vic James is the leading pass receiver for Denver. And they come up double wide with split backs. And it goes to Canada. And he's got some help around the corner. Convoyed for 9 yards. The offensive front did a good job for him. They open with Steve Rogers, 265. Glenn Hyde, 250. Tom Davis, 245. Ron Hassauer, 270. Doug Hoppett, 260. And that tight end, Nozolik, a big target, 6'5", 235. So it is second down at about a yard. Well, it's really closer to 2 yards.
We will also
just over the 48 of Denver, so give Canada 8 yards on that carry. This time they go to Sydney, and the ball may have squirted loose as he crosses midfield and gets the first down. Looks like the linesman marked it. Denver will keep the ball.
Larry Canada and Harry Sydney work very well together. Canada's not a real big fullback, but he's got good strength for the 190 pounds he carries.
Defensively for New Jersey, 3 and 4, 3 down linemen, Lunsford, Woodland, Lockett, the 4 linebackers, McKibben, Joyce, Clemens, Weddington, secondary, Noel, Johnson, Moody, and Williams. And Keith Moody is the supervisor back there in that secondary. He's the boss. First down for the goal. The ball is on the New Jersey 48. Ball goes to Sydney. Big hole over the left side. Gets it to the 43. Where number 47, John Joyce, an inside linebacker from Colgate, brings him down. Joyce doesn't get him. Harry might have broken a big one.
Yeah, but the rookie came on and got him good. That was a pretty good tackle he put in on him. Nice little slashing play off tackle, and John Joyce just came over from his inside linebacker position and got the good tackle.
He is out. Ken Brown is in now. Number 83 at a wide receiver spot for the Denver Golds. Harry Sidney has now gone past 500 yards for the season. Picked up 10 and 2 carries today to give him 501. Vic James comes in motion, and Ken Johnson gives it back to Sidney. And Sidney to the 40. Picked up about 3. They might mark him just inside the 40. Let's check in with Tim Brandt for the word on the tight end for New Jersey, Victor Hicks.
Keith, as you know, he twisted the knee when he was hit on that third down play. He just tried to walk on it, and he was not very successful. They're going to pack it in ice. They don't know if he'll be back in. They don't know the extent of the injury, but he says it hurts on the inside and outside, both ligaments, and they are very sore right now.
He took a lick. Larry Canada and Bo Matthews check into the backfield, so get the 2 elephants in there to go with Harry Sidney. Bo Matthews at 225, good block, a 3rd down and short. The 2 fullbacks pound comes into the middle ahead of Harry Sidney, and Sidney is close to the first down.
Oh, in that situation, you only need 1 yard. You don't need to look pretty. It's not necessary to try and get fancy. You get all your men up front. You get them to wedge in on one spot. You send those two fullbacks up there and help nudge them back a couple of more inches, and Harry Sidney can fall right in for the 1 yard.
There is a relationship between these two coaches. Chuck Fairbanks hired Red Miller as his offensive line coach and then made him offensive coordinator when he went to New England, and then the job opened here in Denver. Red got it. They've remained very close friends over the years. Pitch out goes to Sidney. He's got a man in front, and he turns it well to about the 30. Number 74, Steve Rogers, a big tackle that swung out and was in front, and the pursuit was able to get Sidney from behind. But Rogers at 6'4", 265 out of BYU was really thumping folks downfield.
He was out there very, very quick, but the problem was he got out there too fast.
He
was out there with no one to block, and the man he wanted to block was behind him making a tackle. Now watch. He gets right there, number 72 was out there, and he's got no one to block. He's got no one to block at all. That was Doug Hopkins.
Second down at about 4. From the New Jersey 30. Staying on the ground with it. Slips and slides his way through there, and he's got a first down.
Little bit of running right there shows why he is 5.8 yards per carry. The tackle was made by Rod Schultz, but he came through that line, not a lot of room, and he just picked his way downfield. Very quick, keeping his feet on the ground so he can make the move he wants to make, and he picks up the yards for the first down. Keith, both these teams, I'm surprised in this opening drive, have really gone away from what I think has been their trademark. New Jersey was throwing the ball initially, while Denver usually mixes it up. I stayed close to the ground. I stayed all in the ground.
Sidney again. He's carried it 7 times. And they've got the ball down inside the 21 of New Jersey. As long as they're going to find 4 or 5 yards at a clip up the middle, knowing Red Miller, he'll stay with it.
He certainly will. Chuck Fairbanks has that defensive line, those linebackers playing much more aggressively, I think, now than they have in the past. But Red Miller knows everything that Coach Fairbanks likes to do. Matter of fact, Red Miller knows because he taught him half the things as the offensive coordinator.
Second down and 6. Sidney again over the right side. Spins as the tackler gets hold of him, and he is close to another first down. Sidney has carried the ball 8 successive times.
Well, if this keeps up, we're going to find out what kind of endurance he has, and we have to take into consideration the endurance and the conditioning in this ball game because of the altitude. I've played here several times, and I've run down this field all day long, and in the second quarter, I've been tired because of the altitude.
It's third down and a short yard, and again, they've got the two fullbacks in there now. This time, the quarterback, Ken Johnson, bangs it up the field and gets the first down. He went over the right side behind Hassauer and the center, Tom Davis. And now Denver has the football, first down inside the New Jersey 13.
Ken Johnson just got behind that big block and went over. You know, Ken Johnson is not afraid to run the ball. He ran that quarterback option twice in the game against Chicago in the snowstorm. Two key plays, one getting 8 yards when he eventually did pitch it out, and the other for the touchdown.
They go double wide, left side. First down, New Jersey 13. Sidney looking for some help, can't find it, and he's down about the line of scrimmage. Mike McKibben, an outside linebacker from Kent State, read the play well, penetrated, and brought him down.
That was the first time that Harry Sidney has been stopped without a gain on the play.
They have lost the length of the football. So it's a little more than 10 now on second down outside the 13 of New Jersey. The Denver goal wear the black shirts. Johnson will put it up for the first time. Out of bounds at about the 10, close to the 10. John Joyce chasing him, and Joyce has good speed.
He has good speed. They ran a nice little play-action pass that held that defensive line, so gave him some time. But when he was scrambling, when Johnson was scrambling, he had number 81, Vic James, all alone in the corner of the end zone. But because of the pressure, I guess he just didn't get his head up, couldn't see him.
Ball is just short of the 10. It is third down. Close to 8 yards for the first down. They send James to the top of the picture. Johnson rolls it that way and throws it back across the field. Canada's got a little help. He's down to the 5, down to the 2 before they get in. Good running and a courageous play by Johnson, because Rod Schultz was on a full blitz and he really planted the Denver quarterback.
Rod Schultz was coming from the outside, but when you run a screen, you want the pressure, you want to disguise that screen and get the people away from the man who's going to receive the ball. And Rod Schultz, you see him right there in the middle of the picture. He's coming in, everything open, knocks Johnson flat back, but Canada gets a play, breaks one tackle there. Now he gets a blocking downfield. Right there, he uses his power just to get over for the first down. So it's first and goal to go.
First and goal from near the 2. Sydney, maybe a yard, maybe half a yard. New Jersey defense rose up that time. The linebackers stepped in to fill the gaps, and they held it. Second down and goal. 3.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Matthews comes off now.
Second down. Gold to go. Ball at the 2-yard line.
Canada and Sydney are your split backs. Canada. Larry Canada. Close to the goal line, but a fine defensive play by Keith Moody with help from Maurice Clemens.
It was a great defensive play. Glenn Hyde, number 65, got out in front and gave him a little room. Gave him a good block here, but just wasn't quite enough. Right there, you see Williams playing off of Harry Sidney's block. The rest of the boys came in as he contained it, stopped him just short of the goal line. These are the toughest yards to get on a running play. Everyone's expecting a run. You got all the big horses lined up in front, looking for any break, looking for that ball to be carried across, and it gets tough.
Oh, Matthews is back in there on a wing position now. Figures he'll go to the right side, but didn't give it to Sydney, and he goes that way and sticks his head in the crowd and scores a touchdown.
The kind of drive that will make any coach happy. A team that comes out that relies on more of a balanced attack now establishes a strong running game against that defense, which will allow this offense to open up eventually later on in this ball game or even on the next drive.
Look how much time they ate up on the clock. You've got 2:13 to go, and the Denver possession running 16 plays for the touchdown. They used 10 minutes and 12 seconds.
Ball control.
Spielman for the extra point try. It's good.
Extra points good.
Gets it out of Jeff Knappel's hole, and so the Denver goal takes the lead at 7-0. Another look at the touchdown. He just barely got his head in there.
He barely got in, but look at the defensive line. They're all standing up. He doesn't get in because of power. He gets in because of smart running and lowering his head to get underneath those tacklers.
Coming down off the Rockies in a hurry. It's a high hanging kick. Goes to Lott at the 2. Looks for his wedge, finds a hole up the middle, gets it out to the 25. We're in New Jersey now, we'll go to work. 2 minutes and 4 seconds to play in the first quarter. New Jersey will have its second possession and try to move the ball against the Denver defense. Denver leads 7-0 here in the first quarter, and Walker's got it going to his left. Didn't go very far. Greg Gerken, David Martin.
The defense did a good job right there containing Herschel running to his left. One thing to note about that defensive line, they are offset That means they're set a little bit further down the line to one side or the other. That time they were offset, favoring Herschel's right side where he has a tendency to run. Then he went back to the left, but the defense was prepared for it. The tacklers got over there and he stopped him for a loss of about three.
Second down. They'll put it up on second down. Goes short over the middle with it, and the gain is out to the 30 with Walker looping out of the backfield to make the pass reception. So they pick up about 7 yards on that play, and they'll be looking now at third down and about five, and here's Tim Brandt.
Keyed up with Harry Sidney, 11 carries, 40 yards. He's also on the kickoff team, and the altitude has to be affected.
Oh, yeah, I got a little tired running out on that kickoff team, that's for sure. Just if it was a warm day, it wouldn't be so bad because I get to sweating up and everything, but it's kind of cool and muggy, and just the air is killing me.
Game plan was to run the ball today?
Was run the ball, keep our offense on the field, keep Herschel's team off the field.
Okay, Keith.
Third down and five. Walker goes in motion. Comes out of the flat as a receiver. Over the middle, the pass goes to Sam Bowers. Bowers had it. And it came loose. And New Jersey keeps it.
Herschel picked up that fumble. He was on the outside, drawing a little coverage to the outside, creating a little hole, got back in there and saved the ball. Watch this play. Just nothing fancy, just down and breaking to the outside. He's got a linebacker covering. Does a good job right here, but watch this pop right there. Just knocks it loose. Number 21, David DeMars. There's the scramble for the ball.
Big Fordham Ram, Sam Bowers. And New Jersey has a first down as Herschel recovers the fumble and adjusts across the 40.
It's funny, Harry Sidney referred to New Jersey as Herschel's team.
Yes, he did.
Oh, well, there's a writer in Los Angeles that calls it the Herschel Walker Football League, too. First quarter's over. Minus 1 yard rushing for New Jersey and the time of possession for Denver.
Yes, Denver reminds me more and more of the Pittsburgh Steelers, not just in their colors. That great ball control drive, the defense playing well, containing a great running back, and if they continue to do it, no telling what the score could be.
Walker going to his right. And muscles it up for five. And he did much of that on his own as David Dumars comes up to make the hit on him with help from Kyle Whittingham.
I believe there was a penalty also thrown on the sideline, Keith, and by the reaction of the Denver defense, it's going to be against them.
Yeah, big one, personal foul.
Well, anytime you've got a goal to stop a running back that's as gifted as a Herschel Walker, and you know to stop him, you have to gang tackle him. Sometimes you get a little bit overzealous, and you get in a little late, and maybe sometimes he's just out of bounds. So you've got to watch that aggressive play. You've got to check it just a bit.
Ball has moved all the way now to the Denver 40, where it is a first down for New Jersey. Just starting the second quarter of play. Keith Jackson along with Lynn Swan and Tim Brandt. Here on ABC Sports as Bobby Scott goes back to throw on first down, throws the short zone to Walker. Walker got a first down, and here's another penalty flag. Might be on David Martin.
I don't know who that's going to be on. I saw number 33, Maurice Carthon, getting downfield, trying to get a block for Herschel, and I don't know if that had anything to do with it.
That's a clip.
And it's a clip.
Back him up the other way.
That's a good little play to fake the ball to Herschel, get some of the defensive lines standing there, not looking for the pass, looking to make the tackle, and then once they react to it, you send them downfield, have them just stop about 5 or 6 yards downfield in a little short hook, give it to them, and then let them run.
Harry Sidney had a comment a couple of days ago that I thought was one of the things that I'm constantly pondering over, is how many times can you carry the ball?
Well, Herschel foul, flipping, number 33.
Yes, Carthon. But Herschel is carrying the ball, handling the ball, around the ball a lot. And it was Sidney's opinion that he couldn't do it himself because he felt 20 carries was about his maximum because you just simply wear out. Your legs get heavy and tired.
Well, you do wear out. That's where you watch Herschel. You see Carthon comes down. Right there, he gets a clip.
Yep.
Now, that's somewhat of a questionable call there. When he hit that man, it looked like he was straight up on him. But the official was right there, so I will think he might have had somewhat of a gutter view at that time.
David Dumars was the man clipped.
But you're right. You carry the ball that many times. You take that many hits when you're faking the ball or when you're catching, when you're on the short passes, and it takes its toll. I think one of the examples, if you look at Earl Campbell down in Houston, when he ran the ball, he took a beating. He would never go down. He always fought for every inch. And in the last couple of years, now you see Campbell trying to avoid some of that contact, and he's taking quite a bit. How long can he last?
Yeah. Slows you down. Ball is backed up to the 44, where it's first down and 15. Scott's got it. Wants to throw it. Does. Got a man wide open. It's Bowers, the tight end, and Sam's got a first down for New Jersey as he reaches the Denver 24. Maurice Tyler made the play on him. Tyler at 5'11", 190. A bit of a mismatch against Bowers at 6'4", 240.
Oh, that's a nice little route by Sam Bowers. He's just coming across the field on the cross route deep. This whole play was set up by the play action. The entire defense was just standing around watching because they thought it was going to be a run. And he just got to the zone. Bobby Scott had enough time to find him, to wait for him to open up. It was a nice, easy pass and an easy catch.
And a first down at the Denver 24. Goal leads the Generals. Score of 7-0 as Herschel Walker skips through the middle and finds another 5, 6, maybe 7 yards.
He did that. Half of that was on one leg as he came through. Tackler went low, didn't grab him. He just stepped right over George Atiyah and hopped for another 5 or 6 yards.
Give him 7. Make it 2nd down and a short 3.
If I took one of Herschel's legs, divided it in 2, used him for hamstrings, I may not have been injured so long.
You're right. He's a big one. Walker gets a first down for New Jersey right near the pitching mound. David Martin again coming up on the hit. Denver people indicating it's a hold against New Jersey, and so does the referee, Tommy Miller. So New Jersey makes another mistake.
Left in, number 99, Calvin Turner was down there clapping his hands. Knows that every advantage they can get, they will need against Herschel Walker, against this New Jersey team.
Well, they had a chance to beat Chicago in Chicago. Fumbled the ball away inside the 5.
Holding offense, number 58. 2nd down.
Center, Kent Hall.
This holding penalty goes to substantiate what we've said before about this New Jersey team. Once they get the ball down to the 20-yard line, they have problems. They begin to turn the ball over. They get the penalties. All the things that cost them points on the scoreboard.
Backs them up 10. Back at 2nd down, 11. Back near the 25. Three wide people. Scott goes to the pass, drills it. Pass is caught inside the 10. McConaughey down at the 9.
McConaughey clearly has the best hands in this team. Wasn't used a great deal in about games 3, 4, and 5, but now he's back in the starting lineup. Nice little route on the outside hooks. He almost goes too far inside, but he adjusts, gets back to the outside, and they've got a first down.
Coming up at halftime on our USFL report, halfway look at the USFL, some outside comments and opinions, and what's happened to this point. As Bowers in motion, ball goes to Walker. He's got a little room on the left side, gets tangled up in traffic, takes it inside the 5. If he could have bounced outside, he was gone.
That's right. He just ran through the arm tackle of number 59, Kyle Winningham. Everyone knows that just one man on Herschel, when you just reach out and grab one of those legs, is not going to pull him down. And that was a good example of it. He got the ball down to about the 3-yard line. Now watch Herschel just run through this tackle. He gets the ball straight up the middle. You see the line blocking develop. You see the hole there. Number 70's out in front. Right there, he's grabbed. Just steps right out of it. And then there's the rest of the defense, gang tackle. The only way you can stop a running back like Herschel Walker is to gang tackle.
2nd down and goal from the 3. Out of the eye. Believe it.
Mistakes, Keith. You see that look on Chuck Fairbanks' face. He knows that those are the kind of mistakes that cost you the game, that cost
play
you points.
Play of game, number 10, White. 2nd down.
Automatically goes on the quarterback. Penalties now. New Jersey flagged 3 times for 30 yards and Denver once for 15.
Chuck's got to get those plays called a little bit sooner in there, and Bobby's got to get him out of the huddle faster.
Gene Bradley, incidentally, is suited up as the backup quarterback today, number 12 out of Arkansas State, instead of Dave Boyster. Dwight Sullivan comes in now, replacing Maurice Carthon. Sullivan is in for the first time today. And Scott rolls it left. He's in trouble. Gets it off, throws it in the general direction of Herschel Walker, and it is incomplete.
Oh, Bobby. He is lucky there. He had a rush on, and he had people coming from all over the place. Looked like he was boxed in right here as he tries to roll out to the to his left. Gets a little outside containment pressure there. Now he reverses field. A slip right there prevents him from being sacked.
You got a penalty.
Right there. A little pump fake.
Number 77 reported in Ellsworth. The play is legal.
Number 77 reported illegal. Must have been lined up as a tight end.
Yeah, it was.
And did not report to the official. Whenever a player, an offensive lineman, who is not wearing the proper number of a receiver or running back, when he lines up as a receiver, he has to report to the official so that he is not called downfield just because he has the wrong number for being an ineligible receiver downfield.
Third down and goal from the 8-yard line as Scott goes back to throw. He's got Walker. He goes to the corner. It's beyond the end line. Incomplete. Well, the receiver, Mike Friede, was beyond the restraining line in the back of the end zone. And Scott selecting Friede as his target. He had Walker coming across.
He had them both coming across, and he chose Mike and slipped it inside in between some of the coverage on the outside. And unfortunately, Mike Friede had angled just a little bit too far and back of the end zone, and he was out of bounds.
25-yard field goal try now by Dave Jacob.
Told me yesterday at practice to keep an eye on him because he thought he was going to get in and block one. He felt there was a weakness somewhere. He wouldn't tell me where. Right there, we see it. He gets in clean, and he's got help. And so they block that field goal, which is has to be a big blow now to the New Jersey Generals.
And you'll have in the backfield Terry Miller making his first appearance. He's an NFL veteran of 4 years, along with Bo Matthews. Miller out of Oklahoma State. Quick, right at Buffalo. He's got it. Oh, what a good block. What a good block for number 6-7, Hassauer. And Miller, who is a scooter, comes up the field.
That's probably one of the best runs Terry Miller's had this year. He got some great blocking, but what he did, he let that blocking develop. He got out there in front, as you can see it, we're going to watch his blocking. Now, he could overrun this, but watch him just wait just a second there. A would-be tackle just falls in front of him, waits for the blocking to develop, then he skirts to the outside. Right there, some good running. Cutting back inside, picking up the first down.
And so the banker has a first down for the Denver goal. They're playing on the infield dirt now, just beyond the 30. From the 31. Miller again. This time they read him and get him. Eric Johnson from Washington State comes in, read the play perfectly from the strong safety position, and he drops Miller for a loss back inside the 25.
Well, that time it was number 81, Vic James, a wide receiver who was responsible for making that block. He's got to make the block to give him the room to run outside, and safety just came up and got up to the line of scrimmage with his back turned, so Vic James could not make the block without it being a clip. Then he gets in and makes a tackle for a loss of what looks to be about 6-7 yards.
Yeah, it's about 7. Just inside the 25. Second down and 17 with 10 minutes to go in the first half, and Denver leading New Jersey by a score of 7-0. Ken Johnson delivers it away to Matthews. Matthews out of the backfield, the fullback, gets up to about the original line of scrimmage. They may mark him just a little short of it. Back at the 30, Mike McKibben defending on the play. Well, they do put it at the 30. And it'll be third down now and about 12.
Phil Matthews, a big back out of Colorado, played for the San Diego Chargers. I had the pleasure of playing with Bo in the Senior Bowl when we came out of college, and he's got a lot of enthusiasm, loves to play the game, and he's a guy when he gets into the secondary, he punished a couple of smaller defensive backs.
Third and 12. They give it to Matthews, going to run it from the street right. And they just simply don't have 12 yards available on that play, as the New Jersey defense was stacked against it anyway, and Steve Hammond got Matthews. So now, here comes Steve Gortz, the punt. Last week, he had four punts. 46-yard average to move up to number two in the USFL. Pressure's on him, but he gets it out of there. And he gets a good kick, forcing Thomas Lott to call fair catch back at the 25. A 41-yarder with good hang time. So 9:16 to go now as New Jersey gets to see the football again.
Back of the Boston team, hands off to Tony Davis, who gives it back to Walton, who in turn fires downfield a wide receiver, Nolan France. A marvelous catch. He staggers into the end zone. The point after is good. The game is tied at 70. Down in Washington, Birmingham leads Washington now 7-0 in our FK Stadium, and we'll take you back now to your ball game and Keith Jackson.
The Monday night game in the USFL will be Arizona at Oakland. And right now, Denver leading 7-0, trying with that Pacific Division is so close, trying to get a leg up. A 44-yard flea flicker with Walton throwing to France to tie that game up in Michigan-Boston. All right, here's Bobby Scott back to throw the ball on first down. He's got his man McConaughey. That's a good pass. He had some velocity on it and good timing on it.
He sure did. McConaughey did a good job of getting up in the air. Took a little punishment on the pass. Came down, was hit pretty hard. I think that now New Jersey has decided they're going to have to throw the ball more because that four-man defensive front has been giving them a problem. They're going to use that play-action pass, faking the ball, trying to buy a little bit more time, letting guys like Tom McConaughey here get open in that secondary. And the secondary of Denver can't be exploited. They've given up about 700 more yards, and their offense has been able to get it in the passing game.
Gate is up to the 42, 18 yards on the pickup. Scott goes back to the air, and he's got a man again, and the pass is complete to number 85, Mark Slauson. And Slauson is pounded down, and a penalty flag is thrown, and we might have a little bit of a penalty coming up here on Denver for, again, aggressive play. Nate Miller was the cornerback defending on it, and I think Nate got a little rough on the sideline.
Well, Nate came over. He had a hold of him. He's trying to bring him down. Slauson's a pretty big receiver. He stands 6'3", about 195 pounds, so he's not an easy guy to bring down. He makes a good catch right here, and Miller just wants to hang on. Doesn't want him to get any more yards. Let's take a look and just see where he's calling this penalty. Right there, he's still
first
in bounds.
Foul, late hit, number 50, Black,
oh,
first down.
It's Gherkin.
All right, so he hits Gherkin. Well, Gherkin comes up and hits him when he's still in bounds, trying to give him a little help. I don't know, that might be a little questionable there. You can't take away all the aggressiveness of the defense.
It's a first down at the Denver 25, and Walker on a sweet right cuts it back. And he runs into a LaValle Short, number 92, who's a 260-pounder out of Colorado. And the gain is about 3 yards. That'll make it 4 down to the 21.
He's trying to get out to the right side where he likes to run most, but that time he was able at least to get the gain. Defensive line again doing a great job of pursuing gang tackle.
Right sun now after that little shower passed by. Second down, about 7. Short 7. Walker goes out into the flat. They give it to Carthon. Maurice Carthon gets a chance to carry the ball. And Calvin Turner knocks him out of bounds. Number 55, Putt Choate, had come through and took a shot at him, but he couldn't get a hold of it.
Yeah, he dove at his ankles, tried to get him. He didn't think he could catch up to him, and he was about to turn the corner. So he just tried to sacrifice his body a little bit, laid out there, but he came up a couple of inches short.
Ball ball is marked down at the 14. That's enough for the first down. So a good carry by Carthon. They send Brodsky right and McConaughey left out of the eye. Walker deep. First down at the Denver 14. And the goal stacked in there pretty stiff. They give the ball to Walker, and the linebackers stunning on the play. They were twisting in, and they got themselves burned as Walker had nothing but daylight.
He sure did. He handed the ball off to Walker just to the right side, to the left side of the center, and he just cut back off tackle. Rexler just ran into the middle where those linebackers had vacated that area and picked up some good ground.
He got about 8 yards on the carry. It's going to be second down and two. The ball is at the Denver 6. This is the second time that New Jersey has been down there in the first half knocking on the door. Last time, mistakes did him in. As Walker caught behind the line of scrimmage, but gets back to about the 6. Andy Parimba made a good defensive play, playing at a defensive end position out of the new alignment that they put in for this ball game, the 4-3. Played his college football up the road or down the road at Colorado State. Fort Collins, I guess that's up the road. Timeout is called with 6 minutes and 40 seconds to play in the second quarter. And the Denver goal leading New Jersey. Walker. Didn't get it. He's down at the 5. Andy Parimba again.
Tripped him up. Walker got the ball trying to go to the outside, got tripped up by Andy Parimba. Then the rest of the team came along and laid poor Herschel to rest just short of the first down.
It is fourth down. They will go. They need a yard for the first down. No field goal try. If he runs right, he runs off the grass and into the dirt on the baseball portion. He's going left. It's Carthon, and he's got the first down. Maurice Carthon gets the first down. Boy, he's a tough runner.
He is a tough runner, and since they were going to the left, well, give it to someone who doesn't seem to have a problem or who likes to run to the left. Carthon got it, and he got a little bit of blocking up front, but the first down, well, Carthon got that on his own. He just bowled over a couple of people. Now watch, Herschel Walker's leading right there. Herschel gets a good block, knocks the defensive back just to the outside. He's able to get into the play, but not enough to stop Maurice Carthon.
So it's first and goal, New Jersey, at the Denver 2. A general hurt on the play. We've got a touchdown and goal to go. We've got Brady lined up in a tight end position now, with Victor Hicks having been hurt earlier and Bowers shaken up a moment ago. Ball goes to Carthon, and Carthon is in there for a touchdown. I'm looking to see whether or not he had a hold of the ball, because it looked like it might have been a little hot when Maurice got a hold of it, but apparently he had enough of it and finally got control of it and banged it in for the 6.
I was looking to see who Mike Free was going to block lining up at tight end. He's probably trying to avoid a little contact.
Well, they just rode it in behind the wedge for the touchdown. See if he did have a hold of it.
Mike Free, he's outside just kind of wandering around, and he see right there, he pulls in. He gets over clearly for the touchdown.
That's his second running touchdown of the year. Jacobs in for the extra point try, hooks it up through the uprights, and so we're all even at 7-7 with 5:26 to go in the first half. So the New Jersey Generals finally move the ball without making a lot of mistakes, and they get on the scoreboard. Jacobs now will kick it off, and you can see that Jacobs has been to Denver before.
Yeah, some of the kickers in this league have been around. They may keep going around.
We've got a deep man now for Denver, Glenn Ford. He's out of Lenoir Ryan in North Carolina. He is a rookie, 6'1", 195, number 22. He's a speedster. Kick, and it's long. Forces Ford back 2 yards in the end zone. He comes out across the 20 to about the 21. He was brought down by Terry Daniels for New Jersey. So Denver owns the football now. And Ken Johnson puts on the hard hat and goes out to call the signals.
Well, with 5:16 to play in the second quarter, this is only their third possession of the afternoon, and I am somewhat surprised that they're able to run the ball so well to maintain that control and move the ball down the field. Certainly, we thought they'd present more of a balanced attack and throw the ball much more, but it's been New Jersey that's been in the air.
It's Terry Miller, the I-back, with Larry Canada up front. Miller's got the ball, takes a look, then decides that there really isn't a convenient place to run. Well, he sticks his head in there, and James Lockett.
Keith, not to take anything away from Terry Miller, you know, as you watch this replay, I'm wondering why Harry Sidney isn't in the ballgame. He had a great first drive, ran the ball very well. Then in the second drive, Miller came in. I'm wondering if there might not be some problem down there that Harry Sidney isn't in the ballgame.
Well, he said he was huffing and puffing in that first quarter, so maybe Red's trying to save him some. Bo Matthews is in now, replacing Larry Canada. And back goes Ken Johnson to throw. He has plenty of time. Throw short. That's been one of the problems with the Denver passing attack, because Ken Johnson, in passing right at about 50%, is averaging about 9 yards per completion. So they don't throw it deep a lot.
They don't go for the deep pass very all. They try and throw the ball more to the backside of the backfield. The tight end's coming across to catch a short pass, as we saw there, number 88, Tom Mayer. That's the kind of passing they like to do to balance it out. They try and just pick away at you. They don't really go for the big pass. And so far in this game, Denver has only thrown the ball three times.
Nasolik, the tight end, has not seen it. Johnson back again on third down and six. Trying to set up the screen. And the ball bounces away from Bo Matthews. That's pretty close to being a lateral.
That's right. And Ken Johnson knew that, too. He saw the screen deteriorating on that side. He was getting pressure. He saw the defensive lineman playing for the screen. He backed up just far enough so he could throw a forward pass. It would have been a tough catch for Miller. Better that he dropped it, because there were all kinds of red and white jerseys around him, and it would have been a loss of at least 8 yards on the play.
On fourth down, Steve Gortz comes in to punt. Last time, New Jersey went after him and came close, but he got it out of there for 41 yards, forcing a fair catch. Thomas Lott is standing back at the 30. Well, looks like New Jersey is going to go again. You got 10 people up there, and they're going. He throws the ball. It is complete to third. It's a first down and a lot more. It may go for six. It is up. It is third. It is touchdown.
Number 22, Jim Ford. Oh, what a play.
Well, it's kind of like father to son. Chuck Fairbanks, who had Red Miller as one of his coaches, offensive coordinator, and the son jumped up and said, "Dad, look what I've learned." 75 yards on the play.
Terry Daniels was the only man that really had a shot at Ford once Glenn got wheeling. Look at this pass, the tight rotation.
It was a nice pass right over the shoulder. Glenn Ford lined up as an up back in the backfield right next to the center, just ran down the middle of the field. Everyone was on the rush, so there was no one there to cover him. And from then on, it was a foot race into the corner of the end zone for the touchdown.
Nate Miller was shaken up. Nate Miller threw a big block for Glenn Ford right about the 35-yard line, but he's now coming off the field, so it's Gortz to Ford, 75 yards, and Denver's back on top. I like that.
That was a good play. You know, Denver lost a game to Boston on big plays.
Yeah.
When the trick plays...
Philadelphia, that opening game, too, remember?
That's right. So now they're getting a little justice here, a little balance.
Apple will hold. Goes to Lippo. They go for two in the corner. Apple, the quarterback, throws complete to Larry Canada. 2 points. And it's 15-7.
Ooh. You talk about getting burned. Two trick plays in a row.
Another look at the touchdown.
This is a nice pass. It's just so calm back there. Ford. You know, Ford probably hasn't had many opportunities to get the ball. And when he gets the ball in this open ground, look at that great block there downfield. He's going to take advantage of that opportunity. Look at him just striding out, saying, I've got to get in because this may be my only chance.
Pete, don't fail me now, because Terry Daniels was closing on him but couldn't get him. So Denver goes deep into its playbook and takes a 15-7 lead.
15-7 with a couple of gimmick plays. Punter on fourth down, passing to Glenn Ford. He runs it all the way, and then Knappel complete to Canada for the two-point conversion. Spielman kicks off. It'll be Lott up at the seven. Thomas Lott comes back across the 25.
Lott does a good job of just picking his way down the field a little bit. For a second there, I thought he was going to the outside, but there was just a little bit too much traffic as he cut inside and picked up another 5 yards.
Be tough for him. Here's Bobby Scott on a drop. Has to go short with it. Completes the pass up near the 30 to Maurice Carthon. But there was nothing available deep for it. And right now, here's Tim Brent.
With Harry Sidney right now. Harry, why weren't you in that last series?
I wish I could tell you. You know, I don't know. I think we're just, you know, letting Terry and some of the other backs run. I wish I was in.
Who called that play to Glenn Ford?
We saw how they set up the last time on the punt. We've been practicing on it because they didn't drop somebody back, and we caught them, and it worked.
Okay, Keith.
Yeah, somebody upstairs, probably one of the assistant coaches, spotted it, called it, Red went with it, and it worked. Scott back on second down and six. Throws to Walker, and Herschel's got a first down as he gets it out to the 36.
One of the things that Chuck Fairbanks said he wanted to find out about Herschel Walker when he first signed New Jersey Generals is, how good a pass receiver is he? He didn't do a lot of it down in Georgia, and he wanted to get Herschel Walker free without having to go through that line, through all the clutter in that secondary. And one of the quickest ways of doing it is sending him out into the secondary. He now has three catches for 24 yards.
And a first down. 36. Again to the air. Scott's pass over the middle. Good to Bowers, who is back in. And Sam is close to a 10-yard pickup on that reception. And Bowers, who was shaken up earlier, is hurt again. So that's probably the lingering effect of the first injury to him. So we've got a timeout taken for him, and let's spend it with Tim Brandt.
Thanks, Keith. That was Glenn Ford, who made that spectacular play. Tell me about the play. Where'd it come from?
Well, all week we've been working on this play. It's a special play we put in just for New Jersey. And Coach said we might try it in the beginning of the game. So we went out there and we tried it, and that got me one-on-one with the deep safety. And I knew he was going to catch me once I gave him that fake. I knew I was gone.
Nice play. Glenn Ford, Harry Sidney, both played for the same high school.
Well, he was huffing and puffing. I don't think not so much from the run, but from the fact that he's been taking all those congratulations on the side.
Scott now, 11 of 16 for 128 yards. It is second down and one for New Jersey. Both tight ends are now hurt and out of the game. So they've got three wide receivers in as Scott drops on second and short. He goes over the middle for McConaughey, and he gets him at about the Denver 36 for another New Jersey first down. So they're moving the ball now quite well. When they quit making mistakes, they seem to have good command of the offense.
Well, you said earlier, Keith, when we opened the show, that if New Jersey is going to win this ball game, they've got to get a good game out of Bobby Scott. And being behind now, looking at that 4-5-man defensive front, they've gone to the air more, and they have had some success. Now with Sam Bowers out, 2 minutes to go in the ball game, Sam Bowers is now back in the ball game. It's an obvious passing situation anyway, so he can open it up.
First and 10 from the 36. Scott with a lot of time goes over. Oh, a great throw, the catch, the fumble, and Denver got it. The ball came loose on the hip.
There's a flag on the play, Keith. I have no idea why it's called, but from the position of it, it could be defensive pass interference.
Good. I see it now. Thrown down to about the 15-yard line.
A
little mistake there for the first time, and he's calling it against
New Jersey. So it wipes out
New Jersey.
And the recovery by Denver, I suppose.
We have number 77 holding on the white, number 53 holding on the black. Replay the down.
Oh, my goodness. Number 73 and number 50, and the flag is thrown at the 15-yard line.
Oh. 1 minute and 30 seconds to play in the first half. Ball is sitting at the 36 of Denver. First down, New Jersey. Denver leading 15-7, and Scott will put it up. Has plenty of time. He's getting on the throw through. And finally, Lavelle short. Fights his way through the blocking and sacks Bobby Scott at 30 times this year.
Lavelle short from Colorado, who played under Chuck Fairbanks. He was the head coach there. Came in, put the pressure on. You see it right there. He drops back. He's got pretty good time, a good protection right here to get the ball loose, but he's got no open receivers. And right there, Lavelle short just comes in. Scott goes down. That's beginning to be a familiar place for him right now.
Ball moves back to the 46. That's a loss of 10 yards on the sack with a minute and 25 seconds to go. And here are scores of other games being played today. Look at Birmingham, out to a 14-0 halftime lead with Bob Lane in at quarterback now. Bob Lane's a pretty good quarterback. Michigan and Boston with the Breakers out to a 10-7 lead on Mazzetti's field goal from 38 yards, and Mazzetti is having a heck of a season.
He sure is. He kicked 12 in a row before his streak ended, and he is a consistent man to have in that position.
The power in the Eastern Conference, the Atlantic Division, Philadelphia Stars beating Tampa Bay at Tampa last night by a 24-10 score. And somebody somewhere along the way now is going to have to get a hold of Philadelphia's coattail, or they're going to be out of sight.
Well, they're getting there very, very quickly, and probably the main reason is the fact that their offensive line is so good. The offensive line has allowed Kelvin Bryant to ramble in through secondaries and do what he wants to at will. The defense has played well and have stopped everyone.
Kelvin went for 106 yards last night to take the lead, depending on what Herschel does in this ball game today. New Jersey now with one timeout remaining at 1:25 to go. And it's second down and 20. Deep drop by Scott. Good protection again. Goes to Walker. Walker gets away from one man. He's a tough guy, one-on-one, I'll tell you. Now he puts a little muscle on it, and Herschel, with a strong individual effort, is down to about the 31.
Yeah, that was a very strong individual effort. That was number 21. David Dumars had a chance to tackle him, and again, that great leg strength of Herschel Walker, he just pulled right away from him.
Coming across. Good catch. There's one.
It's a very good catch. Catching in his hands, right there, looking to step away, moving laterally. Now some good tough running, and downfield.
On third down and six over the middle, ball goes to Bowers. I tell you one thing, Sam's seeing the ball a lot in his tight end spot, but his body is getting lumpy.
Yeah, that it is. Bobby Scott has thrown the ball quite a bit to his tight ends. Victor Hicks is a man he normally would be going to, but of course he was out with an injury in the first quarter. Now he's going to Sam Bowers, and Sam Bowers doing a very, very good job for him.
And it's a first down for New Jersey as the ball is marked right about the 20. Scott now with eight in a row. And we've got a timeout.
Keith, New Jersey now is looking at 36 seconds on the clock, a situation where they've had to move the ball quite a distance downfield to try and get a score. Obviously a passing situation, but they do not use three wide receivers. They've only used three wide receivers when the tight end has been hurt. And I'm wondering, don't they want to use three wide receivers because they don't have confidence? Don't they have a three wide receiver package? Or are the tight ends so much better at catching the ball in that situation that they decide to stay with them?
Denver incidentally called that timeout to regroup their defenses. Well, remember in the opening game, the Los Angeles and New Jersey game, the best play that New Jersey brought to the ballpark that day was the tight end. Okay, and they kept it in their book, and they've used it fairly effectively the whole season. Well, what Bowers is doing today, I see no reason not to keep him in the pattern because he's been very effective.
Well, I see no reason not to keep him. He is getting the good yards, but...
You don't get the deep play out of it.
You don't get the receiver with the speed downfield to get the job done quickly.
What we'll have for you at halftime, checking on the other games around the league and a mid-season report on the USFL. We have a comment from Joe Vecchione, the sports editor of the New York Times. We have a comment from Dick Vermeil and a comment from Lynn Swan. Right now it is first down. Ball marked just inside the 20. Scott back. Jackson goes to the sideline to Walker. And Walker muscles his way down near the 10. Gherkin making the tackle. The clock running with 22 seconds to play. New Jersey with only one timeout remaining, remember, so they've got to hustle up here. In the final 2 minutes of each half, the clock does stop on first down. Now they're down to 10 seconds.
Keith, quarterback here has got to stay away from television. He can't preconceive who's going to throw the ball to.
There's your first down as Walker makes the catch inside the 5, but only 2 ticks remaining on the first half clock.
Say preconceived.
Yes, you did.
I did. Wrong word. He can't anticipate a certain receiver being open. Now that, not the last play, but the play before that, he had Larry Brodsky wide open on a corner pattern for a touchdown. I don't even think he looked at him because he had his mind made up to go short. And that time, I'm sure he had his mind made up to go short again to Herschel Walker.
New Jersey has spent its last time out. Only 2 seconds to play, so obviously they're going to go for the touchdown. Walker now has caught 6 balls for 56 yards. So while Denver has come out and gone to its 4-3 five-man front to take away the running game from New Jersey, Walker has suddenly emerged as a principal pass receiver.
Well, now they don't have that extra linebacker in that pass coverage to cut off a lane or two.
What they're doing now, they're moving to send John Bearfield in at a linebacking spot. Bobby Scott closing the first half with a rush. He's completed 10 in a row. He's now got 190 yards and 16 of 21. They've got time for one play from the 2. Scott rolls it right. He's got 2 people. It's a touchdown. Tom McConaughey. Scott hooks up with McConaughey for a touchdown as time runs out of the first half.
He had 2 people running pretty much the same route. He had Brodsky running the same route, a little shallow, and the man comes up and covers him. He goes over the top. Now right there to McConaughey, right in his hands, good catch. Just falls down, make sure he doesn't step out of bounds, and it's a touchdown. No time on the clock.
And they're going for 2. They're going to try to tie. It'll either be down by 2 or tie.
You have to give Red Miller a little credit for going for 2 on that trick play after he scored the touchdown on yet another trick play. He put the pressure on this New Jersey team by going for the 2. To give them that 1-point difference now, if they have, they're forced into going for 2 because if they don't, well, they're down by 1. Put themselves behind.
You figure, at least I would, if I were playing the defense, I think I might guess pass here. So I would think that Miller will go with a nickel defense.
Well, I think you're going to have to see either a sweep or an option pass, like pretty much what Bobby Scott did the last time, where he can roll out, and if the receiver's not open, at least he has the opportunity to try and push it in if they've dropped back too far off, or give it to Herschel Walker or Canada to go to the outside. And if Herschel Walker's going to carry it, it probably is going to be to the right side.
They don't have a nickel defense in there. There's your roll. There's the lob. The intended receiver fell down. Maurice Carthon coming out of the backfield was the man. He lost his footing and fell down. And Scott had nobody to throw to.
That was Putt Schultz, who was right there on the... on his heels, and Carthon thinks that he was tripped up. You might be able to see it from here. As he's running, it's a rollout right there. He just trips up, falls down, and he had a chance to make the play that time, but luck wasn't on his side.
They tried to get the back on the linebacker, and I think that he was open, but would have been open, but he lost his footing and fell down. So Denver leads. Here we go with the second half. 15-13 Denver leads. Long kick way back and beyond the field of play. So it'll be Denver's ball, first down at the 20.
One of the best kickoffs Jacobs has had all year. Traditionally, the games we've covered, not too many of the kickers have been able to get the ball into the end zone, let alone out of the back of the end zone.
So now let's see what Red Miller and his people decide to do here to start this second half of play. They start with Harry Sidney and Larry Canada as the setbacks behind Ken Johnson. Nazolik is the tight end, and the wide people are Lionel Fee and Vic James. And Vic James has not seen the ball at all today.
No.
Not once. The 20. They go to Sidney, and he's cut down at the 22. New Jersey showing that time a five-man defensive front.
Well, they're trying to change things up, give it a different picture. As we watch Harry Sidney get up, we have to tell you that Harry Sidney did not even play in the second half. Did not carry the ball, in the second quarter. Did not carry the ball one time after playing very well throughout the first period, taking charge in their first drive for the touchdown.
Well, he indicated in the interview with Tim Brandt that he was huffing and puffing some after that first quarter. I would think that it's just simply a matter of pacing your personnel.
That and maybe the fact that Terry Miller has begun to do much better at practicing through the rest of the games.
They pitch it out to Canada, trying to get a block to turn the corner. Larry can't do it, gets a yard out of the play, as Maurice Clemens, an inside linebacker out of Kent State, stacked it up for New Jersey.
Kent State. I know a linebacker that's not too bad, came out of Kent State. Yeah. Made a couple of tackles every once in a while in Pittsburgh. What's the guy's name? Number 58, Jack somebody.
Lambert, that's it, Jack Lambert.
He made a few, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
Hasn't he? He isn't through yet either. It's third down. They need six to keep the ball. Back, gets a little heat, tries to set up a screen out there for Canada, but the screen never really got plugged in, and Larry gets up to the 26, so that brings up fourth down, and now Denver's going to have to punt it away. Steve Gortz coming in.
Golden reflection in her eyes and her glasses.
His only punt so far today is 41 yards. The other was a 75-yard pass play for a cutter. Thomas Lott is deep to receive it. I expect he'll kick this one. Booms it out of there. It's a good kick. Oh, it's a dandy. McCoy all the way back to the 20. 53 yards and a pretty good return by Thomas Lott as he comes up to about the 35. So it's a 15-yard return after a 53-yard punt. Denver committed to a 4-3-5-2 alignment defensively, and New Jersey's Bobby Scott has picked him pretty well with a short passing game. He goes to the ground this time with Herschel Walker. And Walker from the... They're going to start this possession at the 36, and Herschel has four to the 40.
Well, I would imagine that at halftime, Chuck Fairbanks took a good look at what they were doing defensively and made some adjustments on that run.
See that Birmingham has built a 21-3 lead over Washington now, with Castro putting the Federals on the board with a field goal. Walker to his right. Good blocking. And just short of the first down. He's up to the 45. It'll be third down and one. Another game being played today in the USFL. Michigan and Boston at Boston, with Michigan leading 14-10 is Bobby Hebert. It's Mike Cobb for a Michigan touchdown. I'll tell you, getting Ray Penny and Tyrone McGriff over there to work in that Michigan line, I'll tell you, those are two quality football players.
Of course, Ray Penny was a starter for us for the last few years, and Tyrone McGriff contributed a great deal, and his enthusiasm is very important.
There's your first down as Walker takes it up the middle to midfield.
as Walker just drives through there for that first down. We're talking about Tyrone McGriff. And people have always wondered, is there enough, have asked the question, is there enough talent to play? Well, Tyrone McGriff was the last person chosen in the draft when he came out of college, number 333. Now, here's a guy who has come along. He has had time to develop, and he plays very, very, very good football. He's one of those guys who will get downfield and block for you all day long.
Bear Branch, player from Alabama. Scott back on first down. Goes short over the middle. Two-yard line goes Sam Bowers. What a day for the big guy from Fordham.
Sam Bowers. He's been doing a great job all day long. He's been getting hit hard, suffering a lot of little nicks and bruises here, but he gets down the middle. Same simple little pattern. Right there, the tackle is missed by number 42, Maurice Tyler. Now then it's just a run. He's being chased by Martin right here, and Martin just hauls him down. If he could have got a hand back there, a little straight arm, I think he had the side, he has the power to have knocked Martin down, but Martin just hung on to his coattail.
Sam probably begging in the huddle now, saying, give it to me one more time. I want my six. First down and goal to go for New Jersey. It is in the middle, and touchdown for Maurice Carthon. So New Jersey chewing up the middle of the Denver defensive front on the first couple of plays, as Walker then took it outside, and that opened up the middle for the tight end. And Jersey's on top 19-15.
Well, if Sam Bowers wanted to score, he had to wear number 34 to make it over this time. Herschel just gets some good blocking and takes it in for the touchdown. You have to give Fairbanks and their coaching staff a good deal of credit coming in after the halftime, adjusting to this defense of the Denver Gold, who they've been taking away the run with that five-man, four-man defensive front. So they went to the air, and Bobby Scott has been having a very, very good day.
They're going for two. I don't know whether that means Jeff is sustaining his kicker or what. If he gets his two, it'll be 21-15. Scott's pass is good to Carthon. And it is 21-15. That was the play they were trying to work at the end of the half of the two-point conversion. This time, they get 2 points. So with 9:59 to play in the third quarter, New Jersey has taken a six-point lead.
Again, let's watch the line block here. Good block there by Slauson on the outside. Good surge by the line, just driving him back. He gets in for the touchdown.
So Carthon gets all 8 points, scoring the touchdown and catching the two-point conversion on this play as Scott rolls it out after faking to Walker. And with that fake to Walker, that frees his linebackers, obviously, and Carthon makes the catch. So the pendulum swings here at Mile High Stadium in Denver. With New Jersey leading to kick it off. Glenn Ford is deep for Denver. It's a high kick, Ford a yard deep in the end zone is coming. Out across the 25, gets it to the 26, and Denver will go to work first down. And see whether or not Red Miller now decides to change his offensive tactics a little bit, because New Jersey shut down their first possession when they tried to run the ball.
Getting shut down like that so quickly coming out of halftime is not something that gives you the enthusiasm or keeps your spirits up. Miller would like to just go down the field and would have liked to have had a more productive first drive, and here he's got to have one, get back on the scoreboard so that New Jersey doesn't get out too far in front.
Keep in mind that Vic James, the leading receiver, has not seen the ball all day. He's in motion. Johnson back to throw it. He goes short to the sidelines. Larry Canada apparently was the intended receiver. As he came out, he got tangled up with Mike Weddington, and Weddington kept him right there. That time, James had headed south on a fly pattern that I think would have been loose if Johnson had let it fly.
I think he would have had a chance to make the play on the ball, and that time just looked like Canada, who he did throw to, was just well covered, stopped short, and the ball just sailed over his head.
Ken Brown is in now at wide receiver, replacing Fee. James comes out here wide with Daniels covering him. Back goes Johnson.
throws it for James, and he overthrows it. He had broken off the pattern right in front of Noel, and the ball was overthrown. Here's Tim Brent.
Keith, Denver's putting their outside linebacker on the tight end all afternoon, and the man in the hot seat is Greg Gerken. And right now, Sam Bowers is having a super day, but how do you stop him?
Well, you know, he's having a super day on catching the inside routes. And, of course, you know, we got to get those linebackers on the inside to feel right inside of him. And then on a couple of those, you know, I got to start working back inside of him and getting a little bit more depth and not getting hung up on their play-action passes.
Okay, Keith.
Thank you. Scott now showing 240 yards versus only 20 for Ken Johnson. Ken Johnson now is looking at 3rd and 10. He's got to have one here, and he doesn't get it. The pass is thrown for Sidney, and Harry can't hang on to it. And it would not have been enough for the first down under any circumstances. So once again, New Jersey's defense shuts down Denver. And Gortz is in to punt.
They've done a real good job. The last two pass plays, they've had 5 defensive backs in the ball game, and they dropped 3 of those defensive backs deep. And it presented some problems when the receivers are coming downfield. And Big James came down the field running that short flag route. He was forced short because the coverage was cutting him off.
Thomas Lott is deep, number 36. Last time, Gortz hit a 51-yarder, 53-yarder. No pressure. And it bangs into a Denver man and is put down up around the 37-yard line. 9:23 to go in the third quarter. Bobby Scott now has hit 12 passes in a row. The USFL record is 16 in a row by Alan Mercer of Arizona. Scott gives it to Herschel Walker. And Walker slides over the left side and runs across the 45 to the 46. That's 7 yards for Herschel, but choked the tackle for Denver.
That time they took advantage of the defensive alignment, and they had the play, got everybody going to their left, misdirection, then cut them back. So now the linebackers are caught inside, had to go through a little traffic to get outside, but it was number 55, Putt Schultz, that was able to get back deep enough to make the play.
Walker on 2nd and 3, going to his right, a little delay, broke him loose, and he's got a first down for New Jersey at the Denver 46. Maurice Tyler made the stop, but again, you get Walker out there one-on-one, and he just absolutely undresses.
Yeah, he got out there that time, and you thought maybe he had a chance to break. He got a great block out there by number 89, Sam Bowers, who's doing just a great job throughout this ball game. Cut up inside, and one or two steps away from breaking a big one.
They send Walker in motion this time. Give the ball to Carthon. Tough runner from Arkansas State, who is quicker, I think, than you really expect him to be. He comes blazing around that corner. Got 9 yards on that carry.
A good balance between Maurice and Herschel in that backfield is going to be a great deal more productive. As Herschel Walker gets so much attention when he goes in motion, when he goes anywhere on the field, he draws that coverage. And Maurice Carthon can just take the ball. With Herschel being a decoy for him, get a little blocking, get downfield and take advantage of it and get some big yards out of it.
Scott looking for his 13th in a row, goes deep, and a penalty coming up. Flag thrown by the back judge, and it may be against David Martin for interference. Defense.
He was covering number 88, Mike Freedy, on the play, and looked like Freedy had gotten turned around.
Yep.
On the play, and as he was trying to spin around to get back in position to make a catch, make a play for the ball, it was David Martin out of Villanova, a rookie, who made the contact.
So the ball moves all the way down inside the 25 to the 24. I like the rule again.
That was number 13, first down.
It was unintentional, not flagrant, and so the penalty is imposed from the previous spot. It seems a much fairer way of doing it. Otherwise, the ball will be down on around the 6.
That's right. I wouldn't mind.
Of course not. Here Here goes Herschel into the middle, again trying to effect misdirection. The gain is close to the 21, so pick him for 3 yards there. Tia made the tackle. He's a big guy, 255 pounds out of LSU.
Well, with a defensive line offset to New Jersey's right side, I think what they decided to do at halftime was just to attack the middle. You go straight up the middle, and if there are a few people on that left side, anticipate making a break to the left side, possibly the big run. While still hammering away at the right side with the strength blocking is.
Brodsky left, McConaughey right, Scott rolls it right, throws it short, Bowers again at the five. First and goal to go, New Jersey. I'll tell you one thing. Victor Hicks may have a sore leg, but he may be about to lose his starting job, too.
Well, he just might, and if he gets well soon, maybe they should go to two tight ends instead of two wide receivers because they are very, very productive. Again, just a little short crossing route, catches it underneath the deep coverage behind the linebackers, and hangs on to it after getting hit pretty good by two defenders.
Bowers has now caught six balls for 116 yards. It's a big day for a tight end.
Now all he wants is that one touchdown. The icing on the cake.
It goes to Walker. And he's got a lot of black shirts. Three of them over there, led by David Dugars, who made the principal tackle on him.
Well, on that sweep, the only thing Herschel got was a little dust.
That's right. They have lost a half a yard. It'll be second down and goal. The ball is now outside the five-yard line, and here comes the play. Brady brings it in, so Brady and Brodsky are the messengers today. 6:10 to go in the third quarter, and the Jersey leading 21-15, trying to pop it in there one more time. They've been impressive here in the third quarter. Walker in motion. Scott runs out of the trap, then he is shirt-tailed and brought down at the five.
That time he was looking downfield for Herschel Walker. Again, a quarterback can't have tunnel vision. You can't drop back. You can have a play where you can design to get one person open, but if you can't get open, you have to have an alternate receiver. This time, Herschel is completely covered like a blanket, but he has no one else to throw to. He's not looking for anyone. Then the pressure comes in. He tries to scramble, and he's brought down.
Third down and goal to go for the five. Loops it toward the corner, and it is incomplete. Herschel Walker tripped as he got tangled up with Greg Gerken.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Greg Gerken is a linebacker with 6'4", 230 pounds. He's 23 years old and a rookie. Now, he may probably only have somewhere between 4'8", or 5'1", speed, but there was so much distance and no one in his way. If he had hung on to this ball, it would be a touchdown. There's just no one. As he comes inside, right there, he's making the play for the ball, goes up for it. Herschel trips over his legs, and there's a field goal attempt.
22 yards by Jacobs, no good. Jacobs has missed 22 in this try. Earlier in the ball game, he had one blocked in a 25-yard try.
Well, the defense, the special teams for Denver has done an outstanding job. They've created one touchdown. They've got the two-point play, and they've blocked or caused two field goals by the New Jersey Generals to go astray, and that means 6 points. Now the fight for the ball. It's bouncing around. Number 28, Eric Johnson, picks it up. Ken Johnson tries to get in there and make the play, but he's got three people that were blocking him. There's no way he can make the tackle. It's a touchdown for New Jersey.
43 yards on that run after picking up the fumble by Eric Johnson, a Cougar from Washington State, at 2:49 to go in the third quarter of play, and New Jersey's going for two. They're trying to make it a 29-15 ball game.
Chuck Fairbanks now trying to put the pressure on Red Miller.
Scott has to spend the time out here trying to get something organized. He's arguing about something that over the ball. He came up over the ball and saw something, turned to the official, and I guess he felt that he was running out of time, and he was trying to call time, and he was not able to effect it, or was he?
No.
He's really yelling it.
Scott,
Tommy Miller.
Scott did come up to the center, and he backed away, and like he was talking to either the sidelines or to an official. Then he came up to the line again.
Number 10.
Came up to the line again and started calling plays, turned around, asked for the timeout, but the official had already thrown the flag.
So there is no timeout charge to New Jersey. They'll just have to eat the 5 yards and go to work from the 8.
Bad place to waste a timeout anyway.
Yep, you're right. Scott over the middle with it, and incomplete, intended for Freedy. There is a penalty flag down.
It's against New Jersey. A couple of Denver ball players are clapping.
So New Jersey gets the touchdown on the fumble and the 43-yard run by Eric Johnson to make it 27-15, New Jersey leading.
Keith, that was the first turnover in this ball game. First turnover and a big one because it resulted in a touchdown.
Denver trailing New Jersey by 12, 27-15. Coming into this ball game, Denver was only 1-3 at home. They had trouble winning at home. First down, the ball is at the New Jersey 43. Up back, Canada. Larry Canada, just over the 40. So here are your statistics now for three quarters of play.
Well, it's been since the second quarter, all New Jersey Generals. They have gained in the second and third quarter 314 yards compared to 56 for Denver. 340 total yards now for the New Jersey team, and I think it was just the Denver team came out at the end of halftime and they were flat. They had no emotional play out there and just didn't execute.
Canada and Sydney are the split backs behind Johnson. Second down and 8, Johnson back to throw. Gets it off over the middle for Vic James. A diving try, doesn't get it.
Just a bit too low. He came across, was open, and just couldn't quite make the get down low enough to hang on to it. Johnson was under a great deal of pressure and did good just to get the ball away. He dropped back, stood there solid in the pocket, waiting for Vic James to come open, and right there, he pays the price.
Third down and 8. Now you get a nickel back in there for New Jersey. Miller in for Denver. It's Miller in motion. Johnson's going to put it up on third and long. He has time, but nobody to throw to. Now he loops it downfield, and it's sort of a fluttering old rag going down there, and the ball falls away, and a penalty flag is thrown.
Well, it's on the far sideline there, and real close to where the ball was marked. He can't guess at what this penalty is. It could be a variety of things. Could have been beyond the line of scrimmage. Could have been unnecessary roughness on the passer.
He might have stepped over the line of scrimmage. Ball was set just barely inside the 40.
Illegal pass.
Yep,
beyond the line of scrimmage. Loss of down.
Loss of down goes with that penalty, so it is fourth down for Denver, and in comes Steve Gortz. So once again, the Denver offense is not very productive.
At this moment, there is no offense. They've been behind and have not effectively been able to get their passing game to work.
Keith Moody now goes deep for New Jersey. Keith Moody to accept this punt instead of Thomas Lott. Might have been dinged up on the last one. That's an end-over-ender by Gortz. He gets a great bounce out of it and a chance to kill it deep. Ball takes a New Jersey bounce and comes on back up the field across the 10. But nonetheless, the Generals will not have very good field position on it. Winds up a 36-yard punt. So you've got 13:55 to play in a ball game. The heat's now on the Denver defense. New Jersey has dominated since about the middle of the second quarter. It's been New Jersey's ball game. They lead 27-15. And they go to work, sending Walker in motion from their own 13. Give it off to Carthon. And Carthon, the fullback, bangs his way up to about the 17, 18. Andy Baremba made the tackle, defensive number for Denver.
Andy Baremba.
Kind of an interesting thing. You read Miller. Got to be frustrated over the inability of his team to win games at home. Red worked himself to the point of exhaustion last week and was ordered by the doctor after spending a night in the hospital to go home and rest. Ron Blanding, the principal owner of this franchise, also ordered him home to rest. Hard to keep him down. Here comes Walker. And a first down for New Jersey as Herschel slips and slides and crosses the 25, gets through to the 27. David Martin on the tackle.
The defense of Denver has done a real good job on Herschel Walker for the most part in this ball game. With that run, Herschel now has 75 yards. But it's interesting to note that I think both coaches have done a good job in adjusting their game plans. Denver came out with the big people up front, the four-man line. New Jersey went to the air, and Bobby Scott has been the difference in this ballgame, completing the passes.
Mike Mason is in at tackle now, replacing Greg Murtha, who left off the field for New Jersey. And Scott gives it to Walker. And Murtha is banged down, short of the 30.
Well, right now, don't look for New Jersey to get too fancy and put the ball in the air too much. They're sitting on a 12-point lead, and they would like for the clock to run down as much as possible. So they're going to hand the ball off to Carthon and Herschel and let them try and grind it out on the ground so that they don't have to take chances now putting the ball in the air, as they've done effectively throughout the game.
See if they'll drag that tight end across now on second down long. They give that ball to Walker. Walker's caught. Look at that. He just stiff-armed one man, knocked him down, but then he is thrown down, and you've got a penalty flag.
Well, that's getting
a lot of black shirts involved in it.
Number 9.
Red's hot.
Obviously hot. Watch Herschel Walker. You talk about the man's strength, and we keep doing it again. Nate Miller, he just shoved him down. I mean, not just a little off balance. He just shoved him down to the ground. And then was gang tackled, and let's hear the penalty from the official.
Herschel foul, unnecessary roughness, number 58.
John Barfield got there a little late. Denver now has been flagged six times in the ball game for 65 yards, and it's a first down. New Jersey out near their own 45. Got some breathing room. Give the ball inside to Carthon, and he runs it hard. He's got it across midfield at the Denver 49. $47,940. Those are the tickets issued for today's ball game. There's no turnstile here at Mile High Stadium, so they can't tell you exactly how many bodies might be here, but that's a fine crowd of 47,000 plus. Ball goes to Walker on second down and 3. And they've got him about the 48.
Now tempers are going to start flaring a little bit out there. The Denver defense knows they've got to create a turnover against this team who led the league in turnovers, and they've got just over 11 minutes to try and make something happen there.
Third down, 3 yards to go.
It's third down, and they still need 3. Was a little bit behind Sam, and he couldn't reach back and get it, and so it is fourth down at 10:49 to play. New Jersey will have to punt it.
Well, that's the first time I can recall that the big tight end Sam Bowers hasn't come through. They fake the ball, a little roll out, gives him time, and he's wide open, just lets it slip through.
Olander, 34 and 32 yards in his two punts, with David Martin, the deep man, for the gold. They've got 10 men up on that. 10 black shirts up on the line, ready to go. They'll get there. Not a very good kick at all, but it takes a New Jersey bounce. Martin fields it. He eludes one, two, three, and goes down. Penalty flag coming up. Might be a clip here. Might be a clip here. Looks like John Joyce coming down trying to help David Martin. Might have been flagged.
I don't want to presume it.
Oh, wait. 33-yard punt.
Again, there was a signal for a penalty, but pushing against Denver. Martin took.
It's against Denver. Personal foul. So the Gold making. They're digging a hole pretty deep is what they're doing. With some big penalties. You know, they're not nickel and dimes, though. That's big stuff.
No, that is. I can't understand why it's a personal foul. When Martin got the ball, it looked like one of the players from New Jersey came downfield and saw Martin trying to make something happen, pushed him in the back, knocked him down, and Martin was still tackled without gaining too many more yards. Unless something else went on we didn't see.
Foul, number 58, half the distance.
Well, it's Fairfield again, so that's second flag on John. Seven flags and 74 yards, and the
back
fifth personal foul call against Denver. And they're backed up now, all the way back to the nine, where they've gone to the 9-yard line, sitting down 12 points on the scoreboard and only 10:38. To play in the ball game. And they've got Terry Miller and Bo Matthews in there as Ken Johnson stands near the goal line, throws to Matthews. Bo's got a first down with the goal as he comes up to about the 27. Second down and three. Johnson drops, throws. Good. Up to the 40-yard line for Terry Miller. Tackled by Rod Schoch. And another first down for the Denver Gold. Here's Tim Brandt.
But so tell me about that penalty on the other side of the field on Herschel Walker.
They gave us a personal foul because they say they blew the whistle way in advance, but at the time we had people all over the guy trying to bring him down, and when you're on the guy, you don't hear that whistle like that, and we feel like it's a raw deal.
Okay, raw deal, Keith.
Johnson, back to the air. It's B again. Lonel Fee, one of Bill Yeoman's players out of Houston. First down, Denver at the New Jersey 40. Now the goal biting off big chunks of yardage.
That was number 21, Keith Moody, that came up, made the play. That was a dangerous pass that time, Keith. Ken Johnson threw the ball well, but he threw it a little bit deep, and Lonel Fee had to back up, literally backpedal, to get position to make the catch. Now, if the defensive back, if Moody had been a little bit closer, then he could have come up, picked that ball off. Anytime you're backing away from a pass, you create a situation where a defensive man can pick it off.
Johnson has hit four in a row. Throws it right. Gets it off. Pass intended for Matthews. Coverage by Maurice Clemens.
Maurice Clemens was all over. And that play, I would have called pass interference. And I'm a wide receiver. And Red Miller, he is livid.
Look at it.
Take another look. Johnson, he's dropping straight back. They do a good job of covering his receivers. Now he's just waving the receiver on, wants him to get open there, right there.
He hooked him pretty well, didn't
he? Yeah, he did a good job of hooking him.
Second down and 10. Over the middle, pass is complete. Caught by Bob Mazulik. First time today Mazulik has seen the football. One of the officials had reached for his flag in that melee, but he doesn't throw it. And Denver players are raising Cain, but there's no flag on it. It is, however, a first down at the 30-yard line of New Jersey. It's getting rowdy.
It's getting tough out there. They've got a team that's trying to fight, come back from a 12-point deficit. They've got plays called against them by the officials that they don't agree with, and I don't know that I don't disagree with them.
8.5 minutes to play in the game on first down. Johnson overthrows. Nick James, incomplete.
carefully.
On that last pass play, he was trying to get the ball over a linebacker's head, just couldn't drop it in, and the ball went sailing on the bounce. But it's a safe pass to throw at that time, because if it isn't complete, it just goes sailing out of bounds.
Okay, Denver needs this win today, and they're going to take a dramatic comeback to get it, but they're in pretty deep. Next Sunday, they go to Philadelphia. Second down and 10 from the New Jersey 30. They hand it off inside. Terry Miller cutting it back into the middle to the 11. He got 3 yards. Try to get it flowing right and got it back against the grain. Time now has become the ally of New Jersey. 7:01 to play in the ball game, and it's now 27-21 ball game.
Some great blocking for him downfield. Number 65, Glenn Hyde, gets downfield and gives him a great block that helps him get in. And look at him, right behind Terry Miller. He's got number 72 out in front of him, Doug Hoppuck, right there. Great block by number 65, and it's a touchdown. Now watch number 21, Keith Moody. He's the man calling all the signals back here. He reads the play. Watch him come up on Hoppuck, right there. Boom, double team. Canada goes in for the score.
The Denver offense came from the defense.
I think so.
The kick. It's good. 7 minutes and 1 second to play in the football game here in Denver, Colorado, and New Jersey's lead now 27.
Jersey's offense may have to get a little more imaginative in this possession.
They certainly can't afford to be conservative at this point.
It's a high hanging kick. A lot at the goal line. Down at the 20. Jersey offense needs to produce something right here to run some time off the clock. Herschel Walker pops it out of there. Oh, that may be a touchdown.
Goodbye.
That's 6 points. It is all over. You'll never catch him. Touchdown, Walker.
Well, we've been waiting all year. We talked about how Herschel hasn't been running to his left. And that time with the defensive line offset to Herschel's right, the play was called. He takes the ball, starts to his right, then cuts right behind some blocking, breaks a couple of arm tackles, and it's a race. Now, we talk about his speed. There's no question about it now. He's got more speed than anybody on this football field.
Herschel Walker now, after that 80-yard zip, 22 for 155, 1,006 yards on the season. He officially has regained the USFL rushing lead after the 106 yards last night by Kelvin Bryant of Philadelphia. Next Monday night, New Jersey is at home against Birmingham. Birmingham had a big day today, rolling up a lot of points. They'll be at New Jersey next week. Jacobs is out. Brady's hold, hits it solid, and knocks it straight through the middle. And now, it is a 34-22 ball game with New Jersey leading. And Herschel goes to the oxygen tank.
And rightfully so, after running 88 yards. That's a long run. Excuse me, 80 yards on that play. Just look at the speed. You wonder how man with that size can
nobody catches
so fast.
This guy once he gets out. I mean, let's face it, he's run 100 meters in 10-3. He loves track. Johnson keeps it. And Kenny Johnson turns to the 11. First and goal to go Denver at the 5. New Jersey leading 34-22. Ken Johnson. Got to get it off. Throws it away. He had to get rid of it. Terry Miller. Terry got
a press box here that cheering their team on with their feet.
I hope that thing stays up there. Third and goal. We got the two big guys in the block. Johnson keeps it, pitches it out to Canada. That'll be
short.
Just short. Boy, I thought he had enough muscle to get it in, but Keith Moody came across along with Maurice Clement. Now Johnson does it.
Touchdown. He gets it.
That's going to bring the ire of New Jersey's defensive unit as the linesman called touchdown.
Well, he didn't get it by much, Keith. He just took that ball and jumped out, jumped up and laid out. He must have gotten in by about a quarter of an inch.
Got a New Jersey man down.
Let's take a look
at it.
Watch a surge. I see a helmet go across, and it's hard to tell if that ball breaks the plane.
Club two, and we get this extra point try. Hold is good out of Naples. Hold, the kick is good. And it's 34-29 as the Denver goal won't roll over. They come storming right back. The 4:07.
Think we'll try an onside kick?
I don't think so. Not with 4 minutes plus. Well, he hung that one up like a rainbow. Walker again. That's the same play that he broke the idiot. Third down and three. Throws it short, pass good to Sam Bowers. Sam Bowers comes up with another big play for the New Jersey Generals. First down out at the 46.
Well, the Denver Gold came up looking for the run, had the defense stacked against the run. Smart play by the New Jersey Generals, putting Herschel Walker in motion, going out for the pass, letting Herschel Walker go to his right, drawing some attention, and then giving the ball, passing it on Sam Bowers. You saw him at the bottom of the screen, just a little short crossing route that we've talked about this team using so very, very often to maintain control and possession.
The ball is at midfield, where it is second down and seven for New Jersey. Denver's defense got to gamble some now. Walker, caught behind, that's going to put it up. Loops it downfield to Brodsky, and he catches it for the first down. Denver, no timeouts remaining. Walker. And he does get out of bounds. So they just keep stringing him out until finally he runs out of real estate. Carthon. Keep possession of the ball and lock away the game. To Walker. Over the top. They've got it. So the Herschel Walker dive over the top, utilizing the great strength in his legs, just sailed over the top. Now Denver out of timeouts. A minute and 15 seconds to play in the ball game, and New Jersey can have four more snaps.
And they can't call a timeout, so the snaps will just beat drop-ons. They're just going to take the snaps and drop right on the football.
80 of those 172 yards for Herschel Walker coming on the one play. Coming on that touchdown, that the telecommunications manager. New Jersey just winding it down. So, this is a big win for the New Jersey Generals.
It's a big win, not just because it's won in the win column,
right,
but it's how they won the football game.
It looks to me like it may be one of those moments in a football team where they finally found their way, if you will.
That's right. They've always had the good weapon, the great weapon, Herschel Walker. Chuck Fairbanks has now got an offensive scheme that utilizes his talents and skills. Bobby Scott came into his own this ball game with a great game, passing the ball, leading his team to a victory.
That'll be the last snap. The ball game is over as the New Jersey Generals beat the Denver Gold 34-29 with a minute to play in Boston, Michigan 28 and Boston 24. Travel arrangements made through promotional fee paid by United Airlines. United flies to Tokyo from more top business centers with three world-class Royal Pacific service. This is a presentation of ABC Sports.